I'm joined this morning with Susan Carr. Susan, you're the Executive Director for our Compass Center for Families in Sheridan. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you for having me. I'm really excited to be here.
So we're here this morning to talk a little bit about WyoGives, which is an exciting time for the state of Wyoming. It's the first of its kind for a 24-hour online day of giving. I know here in Cheyenne, we're very excited. How are you feeling about WyoGives?
Oh, we are so excited. We get to have fun with all of our colleagues across the state and raise money for great causes for families and children and different passion projects across the state.
So let's talk a little bit about your organization. And for those who are not familiar with what you do, tell me how you serve your community and perhaps how long you've been around.
Sure. So Compass Center for Families has been around since 1991, and we began as a CASA program, the Court-Appointed Special Advocate Program. And that program was the first of its kind in the state of Wyoming. It started in Sheridan. We later expanded to Johnson County. And so as the years have gone by, we've really built our mission to be about children and family and strengthening those relationships. And we do that a couple of different ways. We do it through advocacy in the courts for abused and neglected children. We do it through education, through our parent education program that works with families building skill sets and empathy and really making parenting fun again. And we also do it through outreach and resource referral and connecting families and children to all the things that they need to be able to live their best lives and to meet their goals. So we run several different programs through our agency, including the CASA program that I mentioned earlier. We have supervised visitation and custodial exchanges along with parenting classes to help parents do better and be better and really become the parents they always wanted to be. We also provide the parent liaison program for Sheridan County School District number 2. This provides professionals in each one of our elementary schools and our junior high to work with families and school administration to bridge that gap between for communication and really work towards removing barriers outside of the classroom so children can succeed inside the classroom. We also are a high fidelity wrap provider, which allows us to work with families who have children that may have significant behavioral challenges that put them at risk for being placed outside of their community. So we really, we kind of run the gamut from families who need enrichment opportunities for their children, all the way to families who are experiencing significant mental health or substance abuse issues or child abuse and neglect issues. So we really believe that parenting is one of the toughest roads that anybody can go down. And we want to help work with families to strengthen those bonds and to reduce the amount of violence against our children in Wyoming.
So Susan, why did your organization decide to participate in WyoGives?
Well, I think a lot of it is just the camaraderie that goes along with the Wyoming Gives and standing up with our colleagues and saying, you know, nonprofits in Wyoming matter. The work that we do is really important. We want to be able to spread the word about the different type of work that nonprofits are doing throughout the state of Wyoming, whether that be for children and families like we do, or for art projects, or for music, for entertainment, for historical restorations. All of those things are so important. And with the recent economic changes that Wyoming is experiencing, more of that's going to fall on nonprofits, and we can't look to our government to provide all these services for us. And so we really wanted to be a part of a movement that really looked at how nonprofits serve everybody in the state of Wyoming.
And finally, I would believe now more than ever, especially with the COVID-19 crisis, nonprofits need dollars more than ever before. So what would you like to tell your donors or even potential new donors on why they should be giving to your organization through WyoGives on July 15th?
I love the idea of people being able to kind of be at the beginning phase of being able to help families thrive. Because when families thrive, communities are strong. Families are the foundation and the backbone of our communities. And people should give to Compass Center for Families because we achieve incredible outcomes and really strengthen our communities in which we serve by strengthening those families and children. In the long run, prevention of child abuse and neglect saves the federal and state and local governments millions of dollars every year if we are able to get in there early and really make a difference with families. So I hope people do consider Compass Center for Families when they're coming to give for Wyoming Gives, because really it does make a difference in our community for everyone.
Well, we're excited for this event, the first of its kind. We do hope it's successful so we can continue this annually. And Susan, I know you're going to do great things on July 15th, and we wish you the very best.
Thank you so much for including us. We're so excited to be a part of it. Go Wyoming!